Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Sarah and this is a coloring book review flip through for Creative Coloring for Grown-Ups, Mandalas. This is a book I picked up at Barnes & Noble. It was on their discount racks for, I think it was an extra 60% off of what the suggested retail price was going to be. I believe I got it for around $4.50. $4.70, somewhere in there with tax. I have to say that of all of the mandala coloring books that I have, this one is my absolute favorite, and I'm going to show you why. I didn't think I would like it this much until I started coloring in it, and I absolutely love this book. So there are a few pages in here that are already colored, and I will show you those and tell you what mediums I used on those pages. So this is the front. Here is the back. Spine and thickness of the book. Very thick book. So one reason I thought I would not like this book is that the background is already colored for you. I thought, okay, that's going to really distract from what I'd like to put in here, because if the background is one color and I see different colors inside the mandala, what I'd like to put in there, what if they don't match the background? I'll tell you what, I did that on one of these pictures and it made absolutely no difference. The background was something like this color. I'll show it to you here in a few minutes when we get to it. And I did some really warm colors inside the mandala. And you know what? It never even bothered me at all. So the background are different colors throughout this book. They're all different colors. You know, you got your pick of backgrounds and you can kind of choose your colors from there, or you can do opposites and it still looks great. The paper quality in this book is fantastic. It is a thinner cardstock type of paper, and that's another reason I really like these books. The other reason is that they are all one-sided. Fantastic. I'm so glad when publishers do that. It just makes it so much easier for any type of medium you'd like to use. I would recommend using any type of medium in here except for watercolor. These pages, as I found out, do not do very well with watercolor. And actually, the page that I used watercolor on was completely ruined, and I had to take it out of the book. So it will be a review over all the pages except for that particular one. It warped really bad, and I couldn't straighten it out at all. I was very careful on my water usage. I use watercolor all the time, so I know what I'm doing with it. And even after letting it dry completely, before I went over top of what I already colored, it still ripped the paper up. So it got a big hole in it, and I just took it out of the book. So I would not use watercolor in here, but any other medium would be fine, including alcohol markers. Because there are single-sided sheets, just be sure you put something underneath it so you don't ruin the page behind. So let me go ahead and go through the flip through here. You see the background colors are very vibrant, very nice, and the details in this book are to die for. They are absolutely fantastic. You have bigger spaces in some of them, and you have tiny spaces in others. You've got animals, you've got little people-looking things, you've got geometric designs, you've got patterns. I mean, you've got everything in this book as far as mandalas go. This is the one I was talking about where it's the opposite of what I said, actually. There's a warm color background, and I use cool colors inside. And you know what? It made it pop even more. This is something that I would do again and again and again. I would not hesitate using opposite kind of colors with the backgrounds that are on here. And let me show you the detail on here. There is a lot of detail on here. And this particular page I did with gel pens, fine liners, and Prismacolor pencils. So I know for a fact that all those mediums work in this book, and they don't bleed through to the other side. It is completely clear. So those particular mediums would be fine in this book. Here is another one I did, and I kind of stuck with the same color scheme throughout this whole thing. I'm not quite finished with this. the white parts in here will be this color once I'm done with it. So I stuck with the cool colors, as the background was a cool color, and it kind of blended into the background, whereas the other one, it made it pop. So, I mean, you can do it any way you'd like to, and it still turns out fantastic. And this particular one, I painted with gel pens, and that's what the purple is, ombre going down. And there are Prismacolored pencils, and there are watercolor here, this part here that kind of bleeds out to another color, the green, blue, yellow type thing there. That is watercolor. And I only did one pass with watercolor. So, if you're only going to do one pass with the watercolor, it will work okay. The paper still turned out kind of rough, but I don't mind that. It gives the picture some texture. If you're going to go over it more than one time, don't use watercolor. I think those are the only two I colored in this book. But I wanted to show you guys just the detail in these books. And a lot of times, if you've watched my other reviews, I don't really like books that have such fine lines that you can't hardly get anything into. This book, because the dimensions are so large, which I forgot to tell you what they are, so let me do that really quick. It is 8.5 by 11.5. So a lot of times I don't like the really thin areas, but this book, it doesn't really bother me because the size is larger, and they did a good job measuring out the size that a person would need to get in there and color these very small spaces. So if you'd like to purchase this book, I believe that Barnes & Noble still has them on their discount area, and I believe I saw them on Amazon. So either way, this is a really cool mandala book, and a lot of times I'm really skeptical of some of the ones that you see at even Michael's. Some of the ones that you see at Michael's that are their publications, or the Barnes & Noble publications, but this particular one I really, really like. Oh, I did do another one. This one is done with some markers. Markers, colored pencil, and I believe that's it. So there are a lot of markers on this page. And I wanted to show you that I mixed the schemes with this particular one. There are some cool colors. There are some purples, some greens, some blues in different places, as well as the warmer colors that you'll see right through here. And it still made the picture beautiful. So, I mean, you can mix any colors you want on these, and it still just is a really nice execution of color and just everything. I really like it. I have not counted to see how many are in this book, but it is quite a few. And that is the end. So thank you so much for watching. I did want to say I've had a lot of questions about where do I get all my books, if I'm getting them for free, or if I'm being paid to be a spokesperson for certain companies or certain people that do the books. I am not. Nothing that I have on here at this time is something that somebody gave me to do a review for. Everything has been bought by my own self, by my own money, that I work for just like everybody else. And so these are all my opinions. No company's paying me for my opinions or my reviews or anything like that. I have gotten a few of the books as gifts from different family members at Christmas time or birthdays or whatever. And those, I have not mentioned that they were gifts just because I don't feel like that's important. They're not anybody that is giving me the book for the sole purpose of a gift for a review kind of thing. So I wanted to just let people know that. These are things that I get with my own money. And I spend my time doing the reviews and I spend my time uploading them. Every piece of equipment that I have is stuff that I've bought myself. So I just wanted to give people the heads up for that. So thank you so much for watching and listening to me ramble just a little bit. I hope you have a great day. It's a Sunday today, and I hope that your weekend is going great. Until next time, happy coloring.